Okay, I'd like to start my presentation titled Ruby and at the earliest stage. I'm an artist and also I'm a researcher. So I started my career as artist. So at first, I'd like to talk about my artwork. Especially, I use programming language and computer to make artwork. So why I choose Ruby as a programming language? So I'd like to talk about that. At first, this is artwork, Webhopper.
これはウェブホッパーと名付けられた作品。世界地図の上を走る線は一台のコンピューターがインターネットを使って世界中のコンピューターに次々にアクセスしていく様子をリアルタイムに表示しています。インターネットが世界中のコンピューターと繋がっている事実を
then, virtually, you are in Europe and then go jump to the US.So I checked the traffic of the Ethernet line, and then I TCP dumped the packet, and then convert the data to latitude and longitude in real time, and then visualize it on the screen. I created this work in 1996, and then.I received a golden Nika of Press Ars Electronica. And then this work becomes the permanent work of Ars Electronica Center at that time. You see, this is one room of Press Electronica Center. There are many terminals. So visitors can use these terminals.And use these terminals as web to browse web. But you see, in the center of screen, in center of the room, there's a big screen. So this screen shows they are watching where in the world the website. So.Do you know Ars Electronica Festival? Do you know? No? Okay. Ars Electronica Festival is the biggest festival about media art. Media art means artwork using computer or computer programming. This festival started in 1969 as Computer Music Festival.And recently becomes, after that, this festival becomes for interactive art or internet, the artworks using internet. So, I'd like to describe about technical background of this work. This works attached to the backbone of the internet line using, at that time,the WIDE project helps us to make this artwork. So I did the tap to the backbone of internet line, and then TCP dumped the old packet, and then I checked the source IP address and destination IP address. And then I convert IP addresses to FQDN,domain name. Then I convert domain name to address. I use Whois database. Then I use zip code. And then I translate zip code to latitude and longitude. I created this kind of database, and then I convert this in real time. So,I created this work in 1996. I received Grand Prix for this work because of this was the first visualization of this kind of trace data. So I have to use two languages. One language is Perl script language. Another is Java. So I use two different kind of program language to make one system. So I was very frustrated about this situation. So I started find to the ideal language that is a script language, but it's also object oriented. So I started using something like Scheme or Python or Lua and Pyke, and then I choose Ruby to use that. Then I'd like to tell you the next work. This is a hands-on model of the internet. You see, this is a work, looks like a table. You are creating now a packet. You mean a packet exchange system. The internet is based on packet exchange system. The first 8 balls means the destination of the packet. Then next 8 packet means one character. You can send only one character in a packet. So you choose 16 balls in a packet and then send the packet to the internet. These are routers in the internet. So the packet go into the router and the router distinguish where to go. Then the router decide where the destination terminal. This is the destination terminal display of destination terminal. So you see the content of the packet, one character A. So visitors can create your own packet and send the packet to the internet. And thank you. Thank you very much. You see, this is sender and routers and display. And actually, this is using many hardwares. But also, we need software to control the device. There's so many small computers in each sensors. So you see, there's many small computers in the under of rails. So we have to write to control the system. And it was very hard project because we only have half of a year to create the exhibit work. And we start to concept making and then design of hardware, the tower of stainless. So then create the tower and create the electronic circuit. And then we only left one week to write software. Also, unfortunately, we have to use hardware without experience. So there was only a sample code using Visual Basic and Visual C, but the time was only 1 week. So I'd like to use Ruby language. So I choose to use Ruby language and then start using with Win32 API. So actually I used Windows OS, actually Windows ME to use this at work. Then I use Ruby and then use this library. And then I start to convert Visual Basic program to Ruby language. And then day by day, I start to control all of system by Ruby, and also the project succeeded. So this artwork is you can see now in Japan. So if you come to Japan, please visit this Miraikan. Miraikan means the future exhibition center in Japan. So you can see this new version of this artwork. So the next, I'd like to talk about Ruby community. Because I started to using Ruby language because that was born in Japan. So especially there's many Ruby communities in Japan. I am a member of asakusa.rb. Asakusa.rb is one of the most highest ranked Ruby community in Japan. So many Ruby committers joined this meetup. So if you have a chance to come to Japan, please visit this asakusa.rb. Michelle-san came to Japan in 7 years ago and then came to this meetup. So thank you very much. And also, do you know Ruby Kaigi? Okay, thank you very much. We held a big community-based symposium for Ruby in Japan once a year. I'm one of the founder of Ruby Kaigi. And then if you have a chance to come to Japan, please join this Ruby Kaigi. This very big symposium, and so many foreigners come to this symposium. And I'd like to show you one example of state of art Ruby code. This year, we held a contest called Torik. This is a contest of esoteric Ruby programming language. Do you know esoteric programming language? You mean in programming language C, there is a contest called IOCCC. This contest is very, strange program. You cannot read the program, but the computer can learn the program. So we held this contest three times, and this year we held the third contest. I'd like to show you one example, the last Grand Prix, last winner in 2013. Mr. Inaba created this program, and this program wins the contest. But only this has two lines, these two lines. So this program uses only one character once. Then if you run this program, they produce the characters one character once. And then the next contest was in 2015. This is also created by Inaba-san. And this work is this was a more long program, but the first line started like this. Big comma temp equal array. This means looks like a simple program, but you mean this the character and length of character means 3141592 6. You mean this is pi. So if you run this program, you see this program generate pi. This year, the third trick context, so I'd like to show the three examples from the contest. This is judge of this contest. I'm one of judge, and Matt-san is also judge of this contest. I'd like to show you this work. Pen-san created this work. You see character. Please imagine that what will start from this program. Yes, this is Merry Christmas program. よいしょ。Yeah, this is program. Then, let's start and run the code. Hey. That's calculating now.Yes, this code generates a Christmas tree image. Actually, this program has a 3D object in this program, and then this program renders a 3D CG in memory, and then generates ASCII code art to translate it to ASCII art code.This is my favorite work in this contest. Yes, sure. Then I'd like to show you the next work. Next work is Best Spiral Award. This is a code. This is not so long.And looks simple. And let's start work. This is code, and then runs code.You mean, do you know Quine? Quine means self-producing program. The program, if you run the program, the programming print out the gem self. But this program output the gem self as a spiral. And You mean this program uses escape sequence code to control the position of cursor. You can see this like this. So this output contains many escape sequences. But you can also run this program as code.So they contain many escape sequence character, but it runs same as original code. Yeah.You see in this line, trick string is hidden, and also here. And then this is a Grand Prix work. This is also Inaba-san's work. So at the first, to show the, before to show the work, this program do nothing. At the first, this is a reserved word. Do you know reserved word? Begin or end or class. So this is a program by Inaba-san. These are only a reserved word. But this, you can learn this code. This is a program. And then you can learn. Do nothing. You know, this is very difficult because usually if you write this kind of code, this generates a syntax error. But Inaba-san is very good, very good trick to avoid the syntax error. And for example, I'm not so good at to explain this program, but you see many techniques. For example, you cannot put return here, but you can, if false or return, you can write this. So he used this return word as like this. So this is the Grand Prix of this year. And this is the price of this contest. At the first, he has the title Insane. Then he has invitation to Ruby Kai 2018. And also, top five entry will be included into original Ruby repository. If you have a Ruby repository, you can check the sample directory. You see a Torek 2015 and 13 directory, you see the last winner's code in the directory. And if the Ruby 2.6.10 will be released, the code of Torek 2018 will be included. And you see, you can see code from this URL. Then I finish my presentation. Thank you very much.
Questions? Has anybody questions?
Thanks first. And are you working currently on the new artwork with Ruby? What is your current project with Ruby, and what will it look like?
今どんなプロジェクトやってるかってことですよね。You mean I'm what is my current working project? Can I see another slide? This is my current project. This is a future sports day project. Wait a moment. We are currently creating a new kind of sports using high tech, and we called them as sports hackathon. So we collect many gadgets and devices. I think we can use it as sports. So then we did many hackathon using that. So many people start to think about how can I use this device as a game. Then they created a new game using the devices. Then they do future sports day, welcoming citizens. So 200 citizens were gathered in the place, and they battles each other using this kind of gadgets. So we are now trying to create new style of sports through this hackathon event. Thank you very much.